Hello everyone, my name is Bryan Aldana and welcome to this video. This is super cringy and I hate every second of this, but I thought it would be cool to kind of document all of the stuff that I've been doing and all the stuff that I am doing for no particular reason, just to share. I think I'm a very specific part of my life where I think filming myself might help me with a routine. So if you're interested in a kind of a lifestyle, everyday Q&A, and you're like, who are you? Why do I care about you? I'll get to that in just a bit. Maybe you're interested, maybe you're not interested. This video, this is my first video that I wanted to make. A week in the life of a Colombian grad student, as well as a part-time worker in MedTech. Long story short, hi everyone, nice to meet you. Today's Wednesday, January 18th. This is my second day of starting my last semester at Columbia University as a master's student, studying biomedical engineering. And then as part of my last semester, I'm also working part-time within a medical device company, a company that I really love and work that I really love doing. And so hopefully I'll be able to take you along the journey of what the semester looks like. Today's January 18th, I graduate May 17th. And hopefully by then I will have a full-time job. We'll see where life takes us. I'm currently here in San Francisco, California. I'm finishing my last semester remotely. So for today, I actually have half day of work where I'm working virtually. Long story short, I said that already. I sound like my father when he says long story short, and then he continues to talk for another 3 hours. That'll be me. It is what it is. But yeah. I hope you enjoy coming along with the ride. I'm gonna do a reaction video. I usually do headphones so I can really hear it, but for the sake of editing and blah, 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 I think I'm just do it live. This is $20 by boygenius off their album out March 31st. If they go on tour, I will be buying tickets. I know they're going to Coachella. Anyway, okay, let's listen.
It's a bad idea, and I'm all about it. When you wake up, I'll be gone.
The production.
Let me know. I'd be happy to help. I'm gonna start making lunch. I eat and buy things for a 12-year-old child because that's what I am. I'm gonna make big cheese sticks and possibly hash browns. Cheese sticks and hash browns, that sounds good, right? This. Maybe I'll do a video where I do like my Trader Joe's haul that I get every single week. But lunches, I'm left in the dark. It's lunch, it should be easy. So I'll be right back with hopefully cooked lunch.
Mm.
Good morning, everyone. Surprise, surprise. I'm really bad at this, and that is okay. I will be learning. Hopefully, maybe. I don't care. I don't know. But yeah, today's Friday, January 20th. Today's New Music Friday. That means there's new albums and new music to listen to. I had work yesterday all day. I'm on the shuttle ride home. I watched my lecture for my classes, and I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to be taking, to be quite honest with you. It's week one. We're getting there. This is my free Friday, right? So I don't have classes today. I don't have work today. Not even work from home or anything. So I think I want to maybe start working on some music that I was working on already. If you don't already know, which I don't know why you would know, but I do, which you probably actually could see my microphone set up and stuff, but I love writing music, and that's what I do with my hobbies. The past month in which I wasn't working and I wasn't doing anything, that's what I was doing. I was making music. I think I've said a lot in this thing. I'm gonna go ahead and get started with my day. That being said, here's to better vlogs, here's to better everything. I'll bring you along today that I'm not working from home, just like doing things at home on this. And then maybe I'll catch you on the flip side. I'll be listening to some new music that came out today on Friday, because it's New Music Friday. Hello! I have two options. I can watch my lecture. Boo, boo. Or I can work on some music right now. Obviously, one of those is more appealing than the other. I don't know where my voice is at today. Ooh. It's not the worst today, but definitely not the best. So I have to think about whether I should track some vocals or maybe just work on some production for some songs. But that does sound more appealing. But I will say, I will feel better if I do the math. Maybe I should just, okay, music making. This is where I have a lot of songs that are done-ish, not done-ish. There's 15 songs that are mostly produced and mostly vocal tracked and such that I'm waiting for, like, for me to go back and fix them, or ideally someone else, like a mixer, a masterer, a producer, someone who does all three of those would be great, to go back and look at them and be like, yeah, these are shit, throw them out, or... oh, I'd like to work on these and help you make it sound as good as you'd like it. Because in my head, I know exactly what I need to do to make it sound better and what I want to be doing to make it sound better. But because I don't know how to do anything, or how I don't know how to do it right, it's not good. I hate the production. I hate laying down vocals. I hate all this. I love writing a song and hearing the song and then imagining what it could sound like. And like, oh yeah, the song is amazing. But once I start working on it, it kind of like kills what it could sound like, because that... you know, not making any sense. Anyway, with that being said, I want to get through these last eight songs left in this bunch that I want to work on. And I want to work on them quickly so that I can start focusing on new music. Anyways, with that being said, I think I'm going to work on music, because even though it's just like productivity in a different way, right? If I worked on my math stuff, it'd be productivity in classes. If I worked on work stuff, which I'm not going to, because I'm not going to get paid, so why would I do that? It would be productivity in that sense. And then if I work on music, productivity on the music stuff that I really like doing. So I think either way, it's going to be productive. I might jump in the shower to kind of clean myself and feel productive. I love morning showers. I'm a morning shower girly because I love feeling awake for the day. So I might call my mom. We'll see. So I just got out of the shower, and as I was just saying about music, I just came up with a new concept for a song. Okay, this is me TMI. But what brought this on? So Eve Jobs used to date the guy from Chainsmokers, right? And he's now dating Selena Gomez. And I was like, oh my God, that's crazy. Eve Jobs used to go to school with us for undergrad. I was like, girly, I know you. Never met that girl in my life. Actually, don't even know if she actually went to her school. Maybe it was just like a rumor. I mean, it's not a rumor, people. Anyways, long story short, Eve Jobs. And I was like, wow, that's crazy. Steve Jobs passed away, as we all know. And I was thinking, oh, if your loved one who unfortunately passed away was making some amount of money that, you know, some people depended on / relied on, or, you know, in some way or fashion, blah, blah, blah. Anyways. Long story short, I was like, okay, Eve Jobs
dad obviously passed away. So I'm like, wow, how much did Eve Jobs get? Which is crazy. And then I was thinking, long story short is, all I want when I'm growing up and I want to buy a house for myself, if time and life and everything permits, all I want is a humble 3-bed, 2.5 bath. Like, the title in itself is like 3BD, 2.5 BA. I'm like, that's already such an intriguing song title. So now I was like, okay, let me think about what that could look like in a song. I usually do come up with melodies, but obviously they never come to fruition because from melody to song, it just doesn't work out. Like, I'm not musically inclined. I don't know any music there, I don't know anything. So when I make music, I usually come up with guitar chords, track them, and then I sing over it. And most of the time, the lyrics that I write have to change completely melody-wise in order for it to work with the song that I'm writing. So I'm gonna say this, and if you ever hear this song, it'll be completely different. And that's okay, but okay. I think one of my greatest inspirations is like all of boygenius, like Lucy Dacus and Judy Riggers and Julian Baker. It's like the beauty in their songwriting is that they have lyrics and the instrumental supports the lyrics, not the other way around. I don't want a house on the hill. Now, songwriting choice, I could say song, I don't want a house on the hill, or I could say I don't want a house in the hills. Both work syllable-wise. I don't want a house in the hills. I don't want a house on the hill. Both pretty much sound exactly the same. I think I like house on the hill just because I think it's more generalizable. If I say on the hills, it's like California hills. Like, I think that's what people think about. So I'm gonna say house on the hill because I think that's more generalizable. To build. The word build came before I came up with the rest of the lyrics. So I was like, hill, build. And I was like, okay, what do you build? You build a home, right? Out of all the things that you can build, I don't wanna build a house, I wanna build a home. And building a home can look like anything anywhere, right? So I really like that lyric of, I don't want a house on the hill, all I want is a home to build. Anyways, I don't know if anything's interesting to this. I think I might cut all this out, but this is what I'm doing, this is what I do. I was in the shower thinking about my life, and then I was like, 3 bed, 2.5 bath. That's usually how all my songs start. It's like I have a couple lines written, and then when I'm like, oh, this can work for this instrumental, is when I start fleshing up all the lyrics for that song. Anyways, I can't believe I started that concept with Eve Jobs. And furthermore, it was a TikTok about, TikTok that I watched about Eve Jobs getting slighted by this guy from the Chainsmokers to date Selena Gomez. Anyways, bye. Conversation about hyperpop and how Sophie elevated the space, and then other people, not naming any names, have really just. Exciting. Look at my leg songs. I'm gonna put them up. These are my leg songs of the week. Some of these came out earlier the week, so that's why they're like dun dun. But yeah, these are the ones I like this week that came out. Songs that I was disappointed with: I Wish You Roses by Kali Uchis. I was really excited about that one. I don't know, wasn't for me. Fallout Boy, I wasn't excited about that one. Didn't even know what was happening. The Kim Petras song, it was a little disappointed by. But yeah, if you guys have any other recommendations, song recommendations, please let me know. I love listening to new music. All these songs were written and started on GarageBand, and then recently over Christmas break, which was like a month ago, not even a month ago, I got Logic Pro for Christmas, which is very nice. I got it from my partner, knows me so well, knows that I struggle with a lot of the GarageBand things. Or Logic Pro has like a lot more things that I could add and reverbs and plugins that just don't work with GarageBand. So this is where I'm at. I'm going to be recording a lot of vocals. I don't know if you're interested in this kind of stuff, but this is a week of my life. This is what I'm doing today. I am excited to track more vocals and get another track done. This is 16 songs that are mostly done. Again, like I said, they're not perfect. They sound pretty low produced and they're still not great, but they're as good as I can get them now. And then I'll probably iron them a little bit more. And then, but for people to listen to your music, you need to have it all done, right? And I don't have the money to pay for people to get it done, so I do it for myself. And then I don't know, we'll see. Maybe this round a lot of the songs are more produced than the music that I've released previously, so maybe I do want to handle it with more care and have someone else handle it with more care. So we'll see where that takes me, but for now, this is what I'll be doing. I am doing some readings for a class and working on assignments. We'll see what the day takes us. And the hills are alive. Us going up a hill.
Here.
What does it look like?
It looks funny.
It does?
Yeah.
Have fun.
Your whole arm.
Like this?
Yeah.
Hi, everyone. It is 11:30 a.m. and we are on lookout for breakfast / brunch. We don't know where we're going. Anyways, let's see where it goes. I'm really looking forward to today because today we're going to a fancy restaurant. What's it called? Michelin star restaurant for dinner. Thai. That's close to my face.
Okay, people are watching. Bye.
Wow.
We're at the Cheesecake Factory, Union Square. From the view.
Wow.
Bougie, right? Just got back from Kin Kao near Union Square, a Michelin star restaurant. It was so good. If I edit this correctly, you would have seen the amazing food we ate right before this. It was so good. 10 out of 10, wouldn't recommend. If you're in San Francisco and you're around Union Square area, you should go. I definitely will be going back specifically for the caramelized pork belly. So good. Anyway, tonight my partner and I are going to watch the Timmy movie that we've been wanting to watch for a long time, called Bones and All, I think. Timothée Chalamet, Timmy for short. If you know, you know, you know? And we will be watching it, and I'm so excited, and I'll keep posted. I'll do like a movie review maybe, who knows. This one video is going to have New Music Friday review, homework review, work review, movie review. Music making. I also put a clip, but I put a 5-minute clip that I'll probably shorten to like 30 seconds, in which I talked to how I was thinking about a song in the shower. So, too much content. Hopefully you enjoyed all of it or none of it. The week is still going. I think I'm gonna go until next Tuesday because I started on Tuesday, I'll end on Tuesday. So hopefully y'all will come along for the ride. I'll review Bones and All for you. I'll need a night to digest. Wink. Wink face, because it's about cannibalism. So anyways, bye. Just finished watching Bones and All. I will say it is unlike any movie I've seen before. I think on Amazon Prime it has 3.5 stars. I'm gonna go ahead and give it a 4. 4, because it was kind of good, not gonna lie, but also a point off for it to being completely out of pocket, gruesome for no reason, crazy, wild, and so forth. Maybe I'll have some more calm and cool and collected thoughts tomorrow, but what the fuck was that? Good afternoon, everybody. It is Sunday, January 22nd. And it is currently 12:30 p.m., so it is not good morning, but that is okay. If anyone has good bagel shops around the Knob Hill area, hit me up, let me know, drop a comment down below, because I am in desperate need and want of a good bagel. It is now dinner time, a little before dinner time, actually. 4:30. If it sounds like I'm out of breath, it's because I am. I walked up too many hills, but we are on our way to In-N-Out. morning, everybody. Today is Monday, January 23rd, I think. Gotta get stuff done, gotta feel productive. And then the rest of the day, I will be going to Trader Joe's for my weekly grocery shopping that I usually do on Sundays, but we'll see how it goes. Happy Monday. Hello everyone. Okay, as I said earlier, I was gonna work today because I had a meeting scheduled for 9. I no longer have to be at the meeting. So free day again. So I had time this morning to go get groceries for the week. I cleaned up my apartment a little bit. So now I'm gonna treat myself to a little snacky snack. I'm back. I think I zoomed and now, so you can not see my whole apartment. Well, you probably still can. This is my whole apartment. I live in the studio, so you can literally see everything. But I went on my way back from Trader Joe's. I went to the one place that I love going to around me. Again, like I said before, when I lived in New York City, I had my go-to spots, Heaven's Bagels, Heavenly Bagels in the Lower East Side. So good. There's also Cafe One in Harlem, in West Harlem. I think it's technically in Hamilton Heights, but that was my spot there as well. So fucking good. Here, I have one spot, Christini and Java. Really good, would recommend. Best place I've experienced here. In the Knob Hill area, and I would recommend. So that's it. I don't have anything to talk about right now. So I'm just gonna show you this bagel and call it a day. Ooh, that good? I got a ham and cheese on everything bagel. Again, like I said, I usually get like a bacon, egg, cheese with hash brown. Bacon, egg, cheese, hash brown at Heavenly Bagels. Hits so good if you're in the New York area, specifically Manhattan, specifically Lower East Side. Would recommend. Girly, this is the first time I've gotten this. The ham, iconic. Cheese, iconic. Everything bagel, iconic. I think I found something to get every time I'm here. Watching H.J. Evelyn. And eating my Christini and Java, the girl of this bagel. It's good. Okay, that is all, bye. Good morning, everybody. Today is Tuesday, January 24th, I think. Maybe, I don't know. This will be the end of this vlog. I'm excited. Hopefully, if you're watching this, that means that you've recently watched a compilation of too many things all in one video. Maybe it's bad, maybe it's horrible, but we'll see. Trial and error. At this point, if you have any questions or any other content you'd like to see, let me know. That would be great. The city looks so pretty cause she knows I'm about to leave. Yes, I'm leaving, don't need reasons when it's better without me. I know the truth, it's not about you. I wish you knew. Held you tight and made you nervous. Food got lighter, something shifted. Mood got brighter, I deserved it. For all night is barely sleeping. I know you're feeling blue, but one step forward means we have to move.